In the previous class, we have discussed about time of flight of a projectile and the maximum height reached by a projectile motion. In this class, we will be looking at the horizontal range of a projectile. Let's see what is this exactly. So, I am drawing a projectile motion on a xy axis. Let this be x, this be y axis. I am throwing a ball from point A. Let's take it as point A. So, this is a projectile motion. The maximum point reached by the ball or an object is B, then it reaches the point C, which is in the same level as point A. Now, the range that we are going to calculate is the direct or the displacement between A and C in the horizontal direction, and I am indicating it as R. Now, as we have already discussed in our previous video, where the y-axis indicates the vertical component of the velocity of the object that is thrown in a particular direction. So let's take u, I'm taking u as the velocity with which it is thrown, making an angle theta with the horizontal, and in the vertical direction I call it as uy is equal to u sin theta. Why? Because this is 90 minus theta. In the same way, the horizontal component of the velocity, that is the initial velocity, is ux is equal to u cos theta. Now we can clearly see the vertical component is u sin theta and the horizontal component is u cos theta. Now, how should we calculate the horizontal range? You can clearly see the time taken by the ball when it is thrown in a particular direction, making an angle theta, and from point A to reach point C is, see, we should clearly observe that the displacement of the ball from A to C is, you can see it's a straight line, and the time taken is actually the time of flight that the ball takes to go to the point C. Though you are calculating from A to C, the displacement from A to C, but the time taken here is the time of flight of the ball from A to C, the curved path. So how do you calculate the range? The range can be calculated as, range is the displacement. We know the formula, displacement is equal to the velocity into time. So what is the velocity? The velocity is Vx, that is the horizontal velocity of the ball into time. The time here is time of flight. Time of flight of the ball. What is Vx? Vx is equal to that I am taking u cos theta, that is the initial velocity. You can also write it as ux into time of flight. So why am I not taking the velocity in the vertical direction? Because though the vertical direction is responsible for moving the ball from point A in the y-axis, but the range that we are calculating is lying on the x-axis, and that is the exact reason we are writing ux into t time of flight. So what is ux? You can clearly see ux is u cos theta into the time of flight we have discussed in our previous video, 2u sin theta by g. Finally, what we get is 2u square sin theta cos theta by g. And if you further simplify it, you can get u square. This is 2 sin theta cos theta. It is sin 2 theta by g. Therefore, r is equal to what? R is u square sin 2 theta by g. This is the range of a projectile motion. So we can clearly see this particular part. This is ux. This is ux. I am taking as ux. Range is the displacement. Ux is the velocity of the ball in the horizontal direction. And t is the time of flight. Why am I taking the time of flight? Though the time of flight has certain certain value in the y direction, but the time taken by the ball to reach from A to C is actually the time of flight. So we are calculating displacement, which is the horizontal range. Now let's see the complementary angle. How does the range of projectile behave for complementary angles? Now let's discuss the range of projectile for an object that is thrown at complementary angles. Let's take, I am taking this as theta and this is 90 minus theta. You can clearly see 75 degrees is equal to 90 minus 15 and 15 degrees is 90 minus 75 degrees. So what will be the range of a projectile when you project it at complementary angles? You can see the range is almost the same. Let's prove it anyway. So let's take R1 is equal to u square, I'm just substituting the formula, sine 2 theta by g, and let's take R2 is equal to u square sine 290 minus theta. You can clearly observe what's going to happen here. This is R2, we can substitute it as u square sine 180 minus 2 theta by g, and it turns out to be u square sine 2 theta by g. That is, if I take the ratio of R1 by R2, you can clearly observe you will be getting 1. So we can clearly prove here that from the diagram, the red color indicates the direction, the trajectory, the path taken by an object when it is projected at an angle 75 degrees with the same velocity. You can clearly see both the velocities are the same. That is, I am projecting an object with velocity u, I am projecting an object with velocity u. The velocities are same, but the angle is different. The range of the projectile in both the cases is the same. That is, the range R1 is equal to R2. You can clearly see R1 is equal to R2. To put it clear, if R1 indicates the range of the projectile when it is projected with a velocity u, and the red color indicates a projectile which is projected with the same velocity u, and here it is projected with a velocity u but making an angle 75 degrees with the horizontal, and in this blue color line indicates a projectile projected with the velocity u but making an angle 15 degrees. So when this particular case, what you can observe is that range of this particular projectile and this projectile is the same if they are thrown at a complementary angles. In the same case, if you project a ball at 30 degrees and 60 degrees with the same velocity, what will you see? You can clearly see the range of the projectile will be the same. Now let's discuss some special cases related to time of flight, maximum height, and range of a projectile.